happening in there. 4 days going to 5. There is no something
I'm saying. The vortex is around. Yes, that's right. This is fine. It's in the round. You can walk right around the whole thing and it changes.
Actually, I like it.
It's the vortex. It's
rainbow.
Oh, I like that.
When all these rings are circular, this painting will be finished. And that's happening. Oh yes, I must keep talking to you while I do. I'm getting away outside. Okay. Watching. This is where my son did on this wall a picture of a tattoo that I intend to have on my hip next year when I am 66. Because I was under your hands, the lights are in my face, there's your hand here, and up there there's your face, then there's the nurse. I said, look, I have got to do a painting of this, Sandra, because with 4D it would be absolutely amazing. See where I've got that cut in the canvas now? Yes. Sort of, because the painting's moved on. I'm in Bali. You see me rested after my recent adventures in Bali, where I purchased this beautiful bracelet from a very attractive Frenchman, and this one from the gallery of a very attractive Frenchman also, who's now deceased, but this features in the book on his gallery and goes beautifully with this bracelet. So I just made them mine, even though I thought I was pulling the belt in this holiday. Well, I didn't. I did that. And the world's a better place for it, I think. It'll take me through for many years into my dotage, I'll say.
Yeah.
Don't be a drag, just be a queen. Don't be a drag, just be a queen. Give yourself prudence and love your friends. Subway can rejoice the truth. In the religion of the insecure, I must be myself, respect my youth. A different
art is not... Met Lenny McPherson.
Right.
He'd obviously observed me stripping and wanted to meet me.
Yes.
Sandra Nelson said to me, Tuesday night's your night off, isn't it? And I said, yes. And she said, I hope you're not doing anything. And I said, I go to church bell ringing practice at Christ and Church and Lord. And she said, forget that. We're going out to dinner with two very important men. I want you to dress up. And we'll have a great time. Be at the at the front of the club,
yeah,
where the heavies used to sit, yeah, in the dark corner, at 7 o'clock. So I remember well that I didn't have the sort of thing you had to wear. I had to find the longest thing that I thought was the best thing for the job was, I can remember, a cotton hippie skirt sewn up in coloured squares.
Yeah.
And whatever I wore with that. And I got there on time, and there was already someone in the corner, this very exciting guy who was tanned deeply and looked like... Peter O'Toole and,
yeah,
Lawrence of Arabia, that,
yeah,
colour,
yeah,
and,
yeah,
pretty similar, and this blonde-y, whitey sort of hair, and he had a shot silk suit and a wide tie with a diamond horseshoe pin in it, and he was just, I was awestruck. I was introduced to him. George Freeman.
Yeah.
And I didn't know what to say. I said, what do you do? And he said, I'm a crook.
Well, there you go.
Then this other guy came who was obviously my date.
Yeah.
They were talking, he was talking about Sandra and how he had a hard on so hard that he could have knocked down the wall with it.
We will try. So please tell me your inspiration for your exhibition.
Thank you very much. Well, I hope to be finding people of wearing corsets. I made the clothes you'll see tonight 33 years ago. It's wonderful to have them finally out and to see corsets in the street and on the bodies. They weren't when I first made them.
Excellent, lovely. Madam Lash will be around for people to chat with her, ask her questions.
I'm all yours.
Oh, please. You tease. You're such a tease. Ladies and gentlemen, please, another round of applause for Madam Lash.
Go!